boleh nampak slide saya?
Boleh, Madam.
Assalamualaikum dan selamat pagi. Okay, so hari ini kita akan sambunglah, continue subtopik 2.5. Okay, still in chapter 2, elementary matrix. Okay, this is the last subtopic. Okay, for chapter 2. Elementary matrix. Okay, what is elementary matrix? Okay, the characteristic of elementary matrix. Okay, it has a, it is a square matrix. N times N matrix. Okay, this one. N times N matrix. Okay, for example, we have. Okay, what size? Okay, for example of matrix. Okay, boleh bagi ke contoh tak? Same number of row and column kan? For example, 2, 1, 0, negative 1. Okay, this is 2 by 2. And also 3 by 3. Okay, 1, 0, 0. 2, 1, 0. 0, 0, 1. Okay, and another characteristic of elementary matrix. Okay, obtain from identity matrix. Okay, by using a single elementary row operation. Okay, this one is not elementary matrix. Okay, because it is not satisfy the second characteristic. Okay, second characteristic, identity to elementary matrix obtained by using a single elementary row operation. Sini ada word single lah. Okay, for example, we have okay, identity matrix. Okay, 2 by 2. 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay, we convert into elementary matrix by using a single elementary row operation. For example, we use okay, 3 row 2. Transform into row 2. So we get elementary matrix. 1, 0, 0, 3. So this one is elementary matrix E. We use a symbol E lah. E for elementary matrix. By using a single elementary row operation. Dia ada satu je operation. Untuk yang ni. Okay, this one ni, untuk yang ni, contoh yang tadi saya tunjuk ni, dia melibatkan ada beberapa operation kan. From identity to this matrix. Okay, involve more than one operation lah. More than one elementary row operation. Okay, this one, is it elementary matrix? This one eh. Ni nak elementary matrix. Okay, this one, this is also elementary matrix. So, boleh test lah untuk yang ni kan. From identity, okay, identity 3 by 3, 1, 0, 0. 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, we use operation apa? Operation eh? 2, row 1 kan? Plus row 2. Transform into row 2. So, we get this elementary matrix lah. 1, 0, 0. 2, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. By using this operation. 2 row 1 plus row 2, transform into row 2. Okay. Example. Identity matrix to elementary matrix. Single row operation. Single. Ni one row operation lah. Single elementary row operation. Okay, for example, we have identity matrix 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay, transform into 2, 0, 0, 1 using single. This single row operation. 2 row 1, transform into row 1. Okay. Okay, look at this example. Okay, this one. Is it elementary matrix? Elementary matrix one. Boleh dengar tak? Suara saya.
Boleh.
Boleh. Boleh.
Boleh, boleh.
Elementary matrix ke tak ni?
Bukan.
Biasa siapa buat nanti ya? Tak jadi. 100. Is it elementary matrix? Elementary matrix.
Bukan.
Bukan.
Okay, bukan. Okay, sebab apa?
Ada dua operation kat situ.
Okay, dia melibatkan? Two operation kan? Untuk dapatkan ni. Okay, contoh you all boleh buat dia punya solution lah. Proof this is not elementary matrix because from identity to this matrix involve more than one operation. Okay, for example this yeah. Show proven eh. So involve okay into this one. So row 1 interchange with row 2. Menyebabkan ni lah. More than one operation. So 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, and then ni row 2 interchange with row 3. Dekat 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. Involve two operation lah. First operation, second operation. So this is not elementary matrix. Okay, second example. Okay, is it elementary matrix? Number 2.
Yes.
Okay, yes. Using operation?
R2. One over five.
R2.
1 over 5 R2. Bukan 1 over 5, dia 5 R2. Tengok ni, dia punya untuk elementary, dia kan daripada identity to elementary kan. So maksudnya awak untuk proofkannya ni awak kena buat dulu. Dia punya ni, solution dia. Awak kena identity to this one. Operation dia. So identity, kena buat lah identity 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1 kan. Okay, transform into this matrix. So using operation 5 row 2 lah. Transform into row 2. Baru akan dapat ni. 0, 5, 0, 0, 0, 1. So operation dia yang ni. 5 row 2. Transform into row 2. Dia bukan 1 over 5 row 2. Ada identity to this matrix. This elementary matrix. So this is elementary matrix. Okay. Okay, ada soalan tak? Yang lain faham?
Faham.
Faham.
Faham. Okay, contoh lagi eh. Okay, number three. Okay, this one. Negative. One, 0, 0, 0, 1, 85, 0, 0, 1. Okay, is it elementary matrix?
Yes.
Okay, yes. Using operation?
R3 plus R2. 5R3 plus R2.
Negative 5R3 plus R2. Boleh? Yang lain boleh?
Boleh.
Yang lain ada soalan?
Boleh.
So ni using operation, ni awak tunjuklah dia punya ni kan. So using operation negative 5R3 plus R2. Transform into R2. So, buat daripada sini lah identity to ni. To this matrix. So, this is elementary matrix. Okay, ada soalan?
Medius, tak faham yang interchange, apa ni, yang tukar row tu. Tak faham kenapa dia buka elementary.
Tukar row? Yang mana?
Yang first example tu.
Okay, ni sebab dia melibatkan dua operation. Awak nak tukar the identity to this matrix kan? Dia melibatkan dua operation. First operation ni R1 interchange with R2. And then second operation R2 interchange with R3. Sebab dia lebih daripada satu operation. Dia syarat untuk elementary dia one operation. One syarat untuk elementary matrix using single elementary row operation. Dia satu je operation. Ni sebab ada dua operation kan, satu dua. Untuk awak tukar kepada ni lah. Yang untuk tukar kepada matrix ni, dia melibatkan dua operation. So dia bukan elementary matrix. Faham? Faham tak?
Faham.
Contoh yang kedua ni dia satu je operation kan. So elementary matrix lah. Yang ketiga pun sama. Dia awak kena ni lah, tengok ni. Dia ada elementary matrix form identity, kena ingat yang ni. Dia punya karakteristik dia ada dua tadi kan, square matrix and second karakteristik ni. Identity to elementary matrix involve one elementary row operation. Dia buatkan satu je. Okay. Contoh lagi keempat. Okay, is it elementary matrix? Number four.
No.
No.
Bukan. What? No. Bukan square matrix.
Not a square matrix. Okay. Okay, ada lagi soalan? So you have to identify first. What is elementary matrix? Okay, tak ada?
Tak ada.
So we look at the second, okay, representing elementary row operation. Okay, from identity to elementary matrix, we use a single elementary row operation. So what is the relationship between E? E is elementary matrix. E elementary matrix. A matrix A and matrix B. Okay, if the same elementary row operation is performed on an M times N matrix, matrix A, then the resulting matrix is given by the product E times A. Okay, so by the product E times A equal to B. E times A equal to B. E times A equal to B. Matrix A to E times matrix A to matrix B. We transform matrix A to matrix B using elementary row operation. Okay, for example, okay, we have matrix A, okay, 2, 4, negative 1, 3. And then matrix E. E is elementary matrix. Eh? Okay, ni simbol untuk elementary matrix. E, awak kena, memang kena tahu kan, elementary matrix. E is elementary matrix, 2, 0, 0, 1. Okay, so, okay, what is the operation to get this elementary matrix? So, we use operation 2 row 1, transform into row 1 kan? Untuk yang ni. Transform into elementary matrix. 2, 0, from identity to elementary matrix 2, 0, 0, 1 using this operation. 2 row 1, transform into row 1. Okay, then we use the same operation. Same operation ni. Okay, to transform matrix A into matrix B. So, matrix A, 2, 4, negative 1, 3. Okay, we use the same operation. 2 row 1, transform into row 1. So, we get the matrix B, 4, 8, negative 1, 1, 3. So, ni matrix B. We use the same operation lah untuk ni. Okay, then we check. We check this theorem lah. E times A equal to B. So, you all check lah. To multiply this E times A. Okay, then equal to B. So, there's a relationship lah between matrix A, matrix B and elementary matrix. Okay. Okay, look at this example. Okay, we have matrix A equal to okay, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 4, 2, 1, negative 1. Okay, and then elementary matrix. Zero, zero, one, zero, one, zero, one, zero, zero. Okay, prove that E times A equal to B. Okay, prove. Okay, proof. So first we transform, we identify the operation of this elementary matrix. Kan untuk yang ni. So identify this the operation. So operation of elementary matrix E equal to from identity 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Okay, we use operation interchange and row 1 interchange with row 3. So we get this matrix 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. Then we use this operation to transform matrix A into matrix B. Matrix A, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 4, 2, 1, negative 1. Okay, this is matrix A. Okay, we use the same operation R1 interchange with R3. Then we get matrix B. So 2, 1, negative 1, 0, 1, 4, 1, 2, 3. Then you all check. E times A equal to B or not? E times A equal to B or not? E times A equal to B. Okay, cuba check. Okay, check ni you all boleh tekan calculator. Okay, dapat tak? Ini E times A equal to B. Dia mesti akan dapat eh. Kalau operation awak ni betul, dia mesti akan dapat lah. Akan dapat eh. 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. You multiply with matrix A. 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 4, 2, 1, negative 1. Then equal to B. 2, 1, negative 1. 0, 1, 4, 1, 2, 3. So proof lah, proof this theorem. Okay, ada soalan?
Tak ada idea.
Tak ada. Okay, faham?
Faham, dia.
Faham.
Okay. Look at this. Okay. How to determine the size of elementary matrix? Okay, for size n times n. For A size, if A is not a square matrix, eh? Untuk yang ni. For A size, for the size of matrix A, A n times n lah untuk n kan. So in A n times n ni tak ada masalah. Kita gunakan size yang sama je lah. If 2 by 2, so we use elementary matrix 2 by 2. Then we get elementary matrix for B. Then we get the matrix B also 2 by 2. Okay, ni tak ada masalah untuk case 1. Okay, case 2. If okay, case 2. Okay, if A is not a square matrix. A is not a square matrix. Ini katanya for the size of matrix A, itu M times N. N times M. Okay, so we have to check the multiplication of ni lah, E times A equal to B. Based on chapter 1 kan, sebelum ni kita dah tengok untuk chapter 1, we have to check the number, so kena check lah ni. So if A is matrix size 2 by 3 and also B 2 by 3. So matrix elementary, for the elementary matrix, we have to multiply with matrix size 2 by 2. Boleh sebab untuk dapatkan yang ni. So you all kena ni kan check the multiplication kan. The number of column for matrix E must be the same with the number of row for matrix A. Sini. So that we get the multiplication of matrix, the size of matrix B 2 by 3. Itu yang ni, dia mesti sama yang ni. The number of column for matrix E must be equal with number of row for matrix A. Okay, so we get the size of matrix B 2 by 3. Okay, if Okay, if the size of matrix A 3 by 2 and also B 3 by 2, right? Okay, so what is the size of LMG matrix? 3
by 3.
3 by 3. Okay, so the size of LMG matrix E is 3 by 3. Okay. So E, awak kena check lah ni kan, E times A, A is 3 by 2, so equal to matrix B, 3 by 2. Okay, if the size of matrix A, two by four, and matrix B, 2 by 4. Okay, so what is the size of elementary matrix?
2 by 2.
Okay, next. Contoh. If the matrix size 3 by 4. Matrix size of A, B, 3 by 4. So what is the size of elementary matrix?
3 by 3.
Okay. So you have to check. Next, okay, we use this. How to select the identity matrix? So we use to show the row equivalent. Okay, what is row equivalent? So the symbol of row equivalent B equivalent to row equivalent to matrix A. Okay, this one I'm using this symbol. Okay, B is row equivalent to A. A and B are a square matrix. Okay, if there exists a finite number of elementary matrix, E1, E2, E3 until EK, such that B equal to EK times EK minus 1 times E2 times E1 times A. Nah, ni kalau more than one operation lah, we want to convert matrix A. We want to convert matrix A to matrix B. Okay, using more than one operation. So we have, itu ni nak convert kepada B kan. So we have more than one operation lah. First operation, second operation, contoh third operation. Then we have three elementary matrix in this situation. So we have three elementary matrix lah. E1, E2. E1, E2, and E3. So if we multiply A times, so if we multiply E3, okay, ni. Okay, if we multiply E3 times E2 times E1, okay, times A equal to B. Then it is proof. Prove the theorem. This theorem. Prove this theorem. Okay, syarat dia untuk prove this theorem, dia mesti A and B is a square matrix. A and B is a square matrix. If A and B is not a square matrix, then we cannot use this theorem. Contoh macam yang tadi kan. Yang tadi ni it's not a square matrix kan, A and B. So we cannot use this theorem. If there is more than one operation. Ini one operation boleh lah. Kalau lebih daripada satu operation untuk convert A to B, kita tak boleh proofkan teoremnya ni. Okay, contohnya. Okay, ni contoh untuk yang ni lah. Row equivalent eh. Row equivalent. A row equivalent with matrix B. Okay, we want to convert okay, matrix A. We want to transform into matrix B. Matrix B, this one. B. A, 2, 4, negative 1, 3. Okay, we want to transform into matrix B, 2, negative 1, negative 1, 3. So, we use this operation. 2, row 1, transform into row 1. And then, we use second operation, negative 3, row 2, plus row 1. Transform into row 1 to get this matrix B. So in this situation we have two operation and first operation and second operation. Then so untuk ni akan ada two elementary matrix lah. Okay, first elementary matrix okay using first operation and then second elementary matrix using second operation. Okay, first elementary matrix okay using first operation lah. From identity to elementary matrix 1 0 0 1. Okay, we use first operation 2 row 1 transform into row 1. So we get elementary matrix 1 2 0 0 1. And then second elementary matrix. Okay, we use operation negative 3 row 2 plus row 1. Transform into row 1. So we get elementary second elementary matrix 1 negative 3 0 1. Okay, then you can check check this theorem kan tadi kan. Check. Does E2, E1 times A equal to B? Check. E2 times E1 times A equal to B or not? Tadi gunakan row equivalent kan. So we check lah. E2 is 1, negative 3. 0, 1. Okay, multiple with E1. 2, 0, 0, 1. Okay, times A. 2, 4. 1, 3. Okay, then equal to B or not? Check. So, there must equal to B lah. 7, negative 1. 1, 3. Okay, so tapi dia punya, you all nak check ni, dia mesti susunan dia betul lah. Dia mesti E2 multiple with E1 times A equal to B. Kalau you all terbalikkan E1 times E2 times A equal to B, salah. Tak akan dapat yang sama lah. Tak akan dapat equal to B. Dia mesti ikut dia punya susunan lah untuk ni, teorem ni, row equivalent. Tak akan dapat sama lah. Okay. Ada soalan tak? Kita tengok contoh lain. Tengok contoh lain. Okay, tengok contoh lain. Tengok contoh lain ni. Okay, saya akan buka yang ni lah. Ada yang masuk lagi ni. Okay, nampak tak ni screen?
Nampak.
Nampak.
Okay, another example for matrix A row equivalent to matrix B. Okay, we have matrix A equal to (2, 4, 6, 0, -1, 3, 3, 6, 10). Then we have matrix B equal to (1, 2, 3, 0, 1, -3, 0, 0, 1). Okay, find the sequence of elementary matrix so that we can reduce matrix A to matrix B. So first you have to reduce from matrix A to matrix B. Okay, first step of reducing. Reduce matrix A. Okay, 2, 4, 6, 0, 9, 3, 3, 6, 10. Okay, reduce, jadikan 1 eh. First row 1, leading 1. So, use operation 1 over 2, row 1. Okay, and then? Okay, untuk ni apa? Okay, we have 0 kan? Kat sini. Third row, 0. So, using operation, negative 3, row 1, plus row 3. So, 1, 2, 3, 0, negative 1, 3. And then, okay, negative 1 ni, kita jadikan 1 kan? Untuk sini 1. So, use negative row 2. Transform itu row 2. 1, 2, 3. So, kita dapatlah matrix A transform into matrix B. Matrix A transform into matrix B. Okay, by using three operation. Sini. First operation, second operation, and third operation. So kat sini awak kena carilah dia ada tiga, there are three elementary matrix kan? First elementary using first operation, second elementary and third elementary matrix. So first elementary matrix E1. Okay, berapa? E1 dia awak dapat apa? So, from identity to elementary. From identity. 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, from identity to elementary. We use first operation lah. 1 over 2, row 1. Okay, akan dapat 1 over 2, 0, 0. 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. So, this is okay, itu using second operation. 0, 0. Okay, second operation, negative 3, row 1 plus row 3. Okay. So, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. Okay, negative 3, 0, 1. And then E3, okay, E3 using third operation, third operation. Tak fraction negative root 2. Okay, so akan dapatlah ni kan. 3 and 3 elementary matrix. Okay, then we check using theorem tadi lah. E3, okay, theorem dia E3 times E2 times E1 times A equal to B. Ni awak boleh guna calculator eh. Saya check. Boleh. So 100 E3. So susunan dia kena betul lah ni. 0 negative 0 0 1. Okay, multiple with E2 0 0. Multiple with E1. Okay, then multiple with matrix A. It's A1 6. So equal to B, which is B. Tak akan dapat yang ni. Okay, ada soalan? Ada soalan tak untuk ni? Ni if A and B is a square matrix. This example. Tak ada soalan eh? Okay, we look at second. Tak ada. Okay, second example. Okay, given. Okay, given matrix A equal to. This is not a square matrix. 10. And then matrix B equal to. Okay, state a sequence, sequence of ERO in reducing A to B. Then B, find the elementary matrix. Okay, contohnya ni. If A and B is not a square matrix. Okay, untuk yang ni kita tak boleh lah proof yang tadi kan. Kita tak boleh proof untuk yang ni. Syaratnya ni, row equivalent tu. Sebab A and B is not a square matrix. So that we can only find the elementary matrix lah. Okay, cuba buat. Jadi saya akan tanya. sikit ni. Cuba saya tanya ni. Ha, buat kita buat sama-sama lah. Okay, Ain Zulkifli. Okay, Ain Zulkifli. Ada Ain Zulkifli?
Ya.
Okay. First, apa yang kita perlu buat ni? State a sequence of ERO in reducing A to B. Solution. Transform A into B. Do you use operation? First operation? Transform
R1
A into B.
R1 plus R2.
R1 plus R2. So we get matrix. 1, 2. Kita dapat apa?
Kosong.
0.
6.
6.
4.
R1 plus R2.
Eh. 12, 12.
12. Okay, lepas tu. Okay, thank you. Saya tanya orang lain pula. Okay, thank you. Good. Okay, next. Okay, thank you, Ain. Okay, next. Alisa Ariana. Alisa Ariana. Alisa Ariana. Tak ada, ada dua ni nama eh. Alisa. Alisa Yusaimi pula. Kelas apa ni? Alisa ni. Alisa dua-dua kelas yang sama ke apa ni? Oh, dua kelas yang sama. 1A3. Alisa Ariana. Nor Alisa Ariana. Tak ada. Okay, next Alisa lah. Nur Alisa. Binti Muhammad Yusaimi. Okay, next operation apa dia?
1/6. R2.
Kuat sikit boleh?
1/6.
Tak dengar lah.
Tak dengar. Sekejap.
Yang lain boleh dengar tak?
Boleh
dia.
Boleh
dia slow.
Boleh tapi slow.
1/6
dia tu.
1/6.
Okay, 1/6 kan? 1/6 row 2. 1, 4, 2. 0, 1, 2. So kat sini ada 2 operation kan? So ada 2 elementary matrix lah. So E1 equal to. Okay, kat sini awak kena check lah dulu kan? Okay, this is matrix size for matrix A, 2x3 kan? 2x3. B, 2x3. So matrix, elementary matrix, we have the size apa? The size of elementary matrix.
2x2.
So elementary matrix, we have size 2x2 lah, elementary 2x2. So 2x2 from identity 2x2, 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay, use first operation, this one. R1 plus R2. Masa akan dapat? 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay, betul ke ni?
Bukan 1, 0, 1, 1.
1, 0, 1, 1. Okay, second elementary matrix. 1, 0, 0, 1. Now, we use second operation lah. 1/6, row 2. 1, 0, 0, 1/6. Okay, ni tadi solution untuk A yang ni lah. Solution untuk B ni. Okay, yang ni, ni awak labelkan lah. Yang ni equal to, so ni equal to E1. E1. Ni E2. Okay, ada soalan? Tak ada?
Tak ada.
Okay, tak ada. Okay. Tengok. Okay, next tengok ni. Okay, nampak ni slide PDF.
Nampak.
Nampak. Nampak.
Okay, next is inverse of elementary matrix. Okay, the inverse of elementary matrix. Okay, first column is the elementary row operation. And the second column is the inverse of elementary row operation. Okay, the inverse of elementary row operation, we want to find the inverse of elementary matrix. Okay, this one is elementary matrix. The elementary row operation we use to transform the elementary matrix. And this one, to find the inverse of elementary matrix. Okay, to find the inverse of elementary matrix, we have to refer the elementary row operation. Okay, first one, if we interchange row with column, so we use the same operation to find the inverse of elementary matrix. Okay, first ni kita gunakan yang sama lah. Operation yang sama. Okay, second operation. Okay, if K times RI, okay, transform into RI. We use the multiplication of non-zero constant kan untuk ni. So to to find the inverse of elementary matrix, okay, we use untuk yang ni, we use ni 1 over K row 1, transform into row 1. Now you all refer kepada yang ni. If the operation to find the elementary matrix using K times RI. So to find the inverse of elementary, we use 1 over K. Dia akan jadi 1 over K kat sini. RI. Transform into RI. Okay, the third operation. Okay, we use RI. Okay, yang ni awak tukar. Biasa kita akan guna ni dulu kan. K, dia terbalik eh. KRI, KRG plus RI. Transform into RI. Okay, and then to find the inverse of elementary, okay, we use negative K. The symbol is negative, opposite symbol, negative K RG plus RI. Transform into RI. Okay, for example, tadi yang ni. Example, if you use operation, okay, second operation ni. Second operation, if you use 2 row 1, transform into row 1. To find the elementary matrix, okay, then to find the inverse of elementary matrix, we have to use operation 1 over 2, row 1. Transform into row 1. Dia depend kepada elementary row operation. Okay, number 3 ni, if we use 5 row 2 plus row 1, transform into row 1, Okay, then to find the inverse of elementary matrix, okay, we have to use negative 5. Rho 2 plus rho 1. Transform into rho 1. Okay, this one ni dia sama je lah. If we use operation R3 interchange with R2 to find the elementary matrix, then we have to use the same operation lah to find the inverse of elementary. R3 transform into R2. Dia sama. Okay, look at this example. Okay, this is the elementary matrix E1, E2, and E3. Okay, this one is E1. We use operation R1 interchange with R2. So to find the inverse of E1, now we have to use operation, same operation lah, R1 to R2. So we get the inverse of elementary matrix equal to sama lah kan, 1 0 0 1. Okay, we use the same operation R1 interchange with R2. So we get the same matrix 0 1 1 0. So E1 equal to E2 lah untuk ni for the operation R1 interchange with R2. Okay, for the operation for E2, okay, we use the we use operation to R1 transform to R2. Okay, so to get the E2 inverse, okay, we have to use 1 over 2. Untuk ni, 1 over 2 rho 1 transform into R2. Dia akan jadi 1 over 2 lah kat sini. Untuk E2 inverse ni. So we get E2 inverse equal to 1 0 0 1. Okay, we use 1 over 2 rho 2. 1 over 2 rho 1. Transform into rho 1. So we get the inverse of E2 is 1 over 2. 0, 0, 1. So this is E2 inverse. E2 inverse. Okay, next. E3. E3. Okay, E3 we use operation. Okay, basically saya akan suruh guna yang depan dulu kan, terbalik kan. R2 plus R1 kan. Biasa kita guna R2 plus R1 transform into R1 kan. So in this situation, to find the E3 inverse, we have to change the symbol of R2. So we use operation ni. We use operation E, okay, to find the E3 inverse. Okay, we use operation negative R2 plus R1. Transform into R1. Negative R2. So 1. Negative 1. Negative R2 plus R1. So 1, negative 1, 0, 1. Okay, faham? Faham tak? Ada apa soalan?
Faham, faham.
Okay, faham eh? Okay, so ni contoh lain lah. To transform matrix A into matrix B. Ni matrix A transform into matrix B. This one is matrix B. Matrix B is in the form of RREM. Ni RREM. Okay, so there are two operation kan. to operation to transform matrix A to matrix B. 1 over 2 row 1, translate to row 1. Then second operation ni. Tukaran ni kan, biasa kita gunakan negative 2 row 2 plus row 1. Transform into row 1. So to find the inverse of this matrix, so ni E1, ni operation of E1. This one is operation of E2 kan. Okay, to find the inverse of E1 and E2. Okay, for E1, so operation E1, 1 over 2. So operation of inverse E1, I'll use operation ni lah, 2R1. Dia akan jadi 2, tadi terbalik kan. 1 over 2 ni, dia akan jadi 2 lah. So we get the inverse of E1, 2, 0, 0, 1. And the second one, for the elementary matrix, we use operation negative 2 row 1, negative 2 row 2 plus row 1. Then, to find the inverse of E2, we use operation ni lah, 2 row 2. Dia terbalik kan. Okay, jadi 2 lah, ada symbol, different symbol kan. Plus, we have operation 2 row 2 plus row 1. Transform into row 1. So we get E2 inverse, 1, 2, 0, 1. Yang ni kita gunakan, yang tadilah nak transform tu kita akan gunakan yang row equivalent tu. A is row equivalent to matrix B. Okay then, okay, the inverse of elementary matrix, so A equal to, we can check lah either the inverse of matrix correct or not, and we can check using this theorem. A equal to, okay, this one tadi ada two elementary matrix kan, E1 and E2 inverse kan. So ni we get E2 inverse, apa nak terbalik, E1 inverse. So A equal to E1 inverse multiple with E2 inverse. Then multiple with I. I is identity. Equal to A. Then the second theorem. Okay ni first theorem. First theorem ni untuk dapatkan second theorem lah. Second theorem is to find the inverse of A. Okay, before this, we have learned in chapter 2. The inverse 2. Previous subtopic kan? 2.4 kan? We have to, we want to find the inverse of matrix. We have to use formula and we have to reduce the matrix using elementary row operation kan? Okay, this one is another method lah to find the inverse of A. We can use the elementary matrix. So A inverse equal to, dia ni terbalik kan, E. So E2, tadi E, ada dua kan, 2. So E2 multiple with E1. Equal to A inverse. Cuba you all check yang tadi. Yang ni kan. Okay, cuba check dia punya A inverse. A inverse by using formula. Sebelum ni kita guna formula dia kan. 1 over determinant kan. Determinant is 2 minus 0 kan. 1 over AD minus BC. So this one 1, 2, negative 4, 0. So we get the inverse, okay ni the inverse, A inverse. Okay, equal to, okay 1 over 2, negative 2, 0 and 1 kan. By using formula. Okay, by using elementary matrix. Okay, cuba check elementary matrix. So, elementary matrix tadi A inverse equal to. Ni kan, E2 multiple with E1. E2 multiple with E1. By using elementary matrix. Ada dua method lah maksudnya untuk cari. Ada tiga method lah sebenarnya kan. Formula, elementary matrix dengan elementary row operation. Okay, check ni. Itu, itu kita buat apa? Okay, itu using operation ni kan. E, itu akan dapat 1 over 2 row 1. So 1 over 2 itu ni. 1 over 2 0 0 1. Itu. E1. E1. Itu. Negatif. Benda ni lah. Negatif 2 row 2 plus row 1. 0 1. Salin dulu. Negatif 2 row 2 plus row 1. Get 1. Negatif row 2. Negatif 2. So itu 1 negative 2 0 1 okay, multiple with E1 1 over 2 0 0 1 so akan dapat ni lah sama 1 over 2 negative 2 0 1 sama. So selain nak gunakan elementary row operation and formula, we can use elementary matrix to find the inverse. Okay, ada soalan? Ni tadi lah. So dah habis lah untuk chapter ni. So this is a summary ya. Summary for elementary matrix. Okay, and property of invertible matrix. Okay, each elementary matrix E is invertible and the inverse matrix E inverse is also an elementary matrix. Okay, a square matrix A is invertible if and only if it can be written as a product of elementary matrix. And then the summary for equivalent condition. Okay, if A is a square matrix n times n, can the following statement are equivalent? Okay, A is invertible. Okay, number two, AX equal to B as a unit solution for every n times n, for every n times 1 column matrix B. Okay, this one untuk ni lah. Untuk system, solving for system of linear equation and system of linear equation. Linear equation. Okay, next number 3. AX equal to 0 has only a trivial solution. Okay, this one untuk homogeneous system. Homogeneous. Homogeneous system. So homogeneous system always trivial solution. For system of linear equation, always unique solution. Okay, and then A is true equivalent to identity matrix. And last one, A can be written as product of elementary matrix. Ini yang tadi lah, A product of elementary matrix A equal to yang sebelum ni. Ni E1 inverse, E2 inverse. E1 inverse multiple with E2 inverse. Okay, Okay, summary for all chapter 2. Okay, summary for all chapter 2. Okay, using Gauss-Jordan method, we have to reduce the matrix into RREM. Ini summary semua. Ya, kena tahulah kan ni. Reduce into RREM. Then second, by using a Gaussian method, we have to reduce into REM, rho epsilon matrix. REM form. Okay, there are three types of solution. The unit solution, many solution and no solution. For no solution is inconsistent solution. We call it inconsistent. For many and unique, consistent. Okay, and number four, in homogeneous system, there's only two solution and always consistent, which is trivial and non-trivial solution. Okay, number four, for homogeneous system. Okay, number five, elementary matrix. Okay, it's a square matrix obtained by single operation on identity matrix. Yang tadi lah kan, I convert into elementary. You use single ERO. First, use a single ERO. Okay, and then the size of an elementary matrix depend on the number of row of a matrix A. If EA equal to B. Okay, and then the inverse of elementary matrix is obtained by the inverse operation of elementary row operation. Ini saya tunjuk tadi lah yang ada tiga tu kan. Number 7 ni ada three operation of ERO. And then, okay, if A and B are row equivalent, then B equal to E2 EK times EK minus 1 times E2 times E1 times A. Okay, and then matrix A can be written as a product of elementary matrix. Ha, ni yang tadi saya tunjukkan. A equal to E1 inverse times E2 inverse. Nanti E2 inverse. Then last one, the inverse of A can be obtained from the multiplication of elementary matrix. Ha, ini pun kita dah proof tadi kan. A inverse equal to EK times E3 times E2 times E1. Okay, susunan dia kena betul lah untuk yang ni, dua ni. Kalau dia suruh proof kan, ha, you all kena susun betul lah ni. Dia kena, susunan dia kena make sure betul. The order of E, elementary matrix tu. Okay, untuk ni E3 dulu kan, E3. Untuk A inverse, E3 times E2, E1. Susunan dia menurun lah. Untuk ni find the proof the A, susunan of inverse dia menaik. 1, 2, 3. Nah, yang ni pun kena tahu, kena ingat juga susunan dia. E2 times E1 times A equal to B. Okay. So this next reference from books ni lah, linear algebra. Okay, ada soalan? Okay, so dah habis lah untuk ni chapter 2 ni.
Madam.
Ya? Yeah?
Kalau nak tanya pasal tutorial 2 boleh tak?
Boleh.
Untuk nombor yang Disember 2015.
Okay, kita tengok tutorial 2 eh. Yang lain dah cuba buat tutorial 2. Sekejap, kita tengok soalan. Okay, tutorial 2. Okay, mana?
Oh, December 2015.
December? Cakap kuat sikit boleh tak? Tak dengar.
December 2015.
December 2015. Okay.
Yang B. Konsisten tu.
Such that the system is consistent. Consistent ni lah, kena consistent tadi kan ada, dah ada conclusion dia kan. Consistent ni two operation, there are two solution lah kat sini. Two solution lah, ni ada dua. Many solution dengan unique solution. Many and unique. Untuk consistent, kalau inconsistent, no solution. Boleh? So, kena reduce lah. Reduce this system, this matrix into, okay, reduce sampai you all dapat RREM in RREM form. So nanti untuk last row dia kita refer kepada ni, for many solution. Sebelum ni ada kan dia punya tips kan untuk many solution, teorem dia apa? Equal to zero kan? Yang untuk last, kita refer kepada last row. Dia punya ni. Last column and untuk yang ni lah. Okay. Untuk last ni. For unique solution. Not equal to zero.
Real number.
Ni any real number. Okay. Faham? Alia.
Kalau macam kat belah kiri je dia punya K tu ada. Maksudnya kena buat macam mana?
Macam mana? K sebelah kiri, sebelah sini eh?
Yang belah tu je yang ada K. Kan selalu kalau nak buat yang untuk many solution dengan ni kan dia dua-dua belah kena ada, boleh ubah tu kan?
Oh, kalau sebelah ada K, tengok K je lah. Tengok yang sebelah sini je lah.
Oh, okey. Faham.
Kalau untuk macam ni, dia tak akan dapat many solution kot. Dia boleh, sebab sini awak dapat apa? Zero. Boleh dapat zero. Untuk right hand side dia. Untuk constant.
Memang dapat zero.
Last dapat apa? Cuba, dapat. Dah reduce. Dapat apa last? Dah reduce.
100.
100. Biasa?
010.
010.
0, 0, 1 over 2k. 0, 0.
1 over 2k. Over k.
No. 1 over 2k.
1 over 2k.
Equal
to?
2, 1, 3.
3. Ni macam ni. So check lah kat sini. Many solution. Okay, ni many solution tak? So untuk left hand, okay, dia tak boleh, dia bukan many solution lah kan? Sebab untuk yang awak punya right hand side ni, dia tak zero kan? So lagi satu, dia bukan many solution lah ni, dia punya sistem consistent kan? So selain daripada tu, dia unique, boleh check dia unique solution je lah. Many solution tak boleh lah sebab right hand side not equal to zero. So the unique solution. Unique solution if unique solution not equal, left hand side not equal to zero. So 1 over 2, k not equal to zero. So k not equal to zero lah.
Madam.
Yeah.
Dia k over 2 bukan
K over 2. K over 2 ke 1 over 2 ke?
Saya dah macam ikut yang kat soalan lah.
K over 2. Yang lain dapat apa? K over 2 ke 1 over 2 ke?
Tak, K tu dekat luar bukan bawah. Bawah K. Eh bukan bawah. Bukan.
Kat luar. Sumi atas.
Kat luar. Satu per 2 K tepi.
Oh, 1 per 2 K. Sekejap. Bukan 1 over 2K.
Okay.
Satu per 2 K. Saya dapat sama lah juga kan? Over 2K. Nak ikut tu 0. So K. Nak ikut tu 0 lah juga. Lepas ni K nak ikut tu 0 lah. Many solution dia tak mungkin lah sebab untuk orang asap ni nak ikut many solution ikut tu 0 kan. K is, jawapan dia K is unit solution if K nak ikut tu 0. Okay, lain? Ada soalan? Ni tutorial ni kelas saya ke apa? Kelas senaja.
Saya kelas senaja.
Kelas senaja.
Madam, nak tanya nanti madam bagi skema tak tutorial tu?
Saya bagi jawapan lah. Tengoklah sikit. Itu skema kan. Kalau tak ni saya bagi jawapan je lah. Kena cari sendiri lah. Saya bagi jawapan akhir.
Okay.
So untuk tutorial minggu ni awak siapkanlah semua. Mana dengan saya siapkan semua. Nanti baru saya akan bagi jawapan lah. Banyak kan ni kan? Okay. Lagi ada soalan untuk yang ni? Dah buat semua. Tak ada soalan eh? Kita ada soalan, kita boleh stop lah sampai sini. So untuk this week tutorial boleh siapkan tutorial chapter 2. Okay, so next week kita akan masuk chapter 3 lah, determinant. Okay, and then you all punya, okay sekejap. Punya you future kena tick lah.